Cubase 11 and Melodyne, that's the way to work nowadays with samples. Complete freedom as regards tempo, harmonies, and chords. Here's how. This guitar sample was originally two bars with only one chord, but now it's playing along with the song in a way that sounds just right. I'll show you now step by step how to get there. Let's start at the beginning with just the drums. And here's the original sample. The tempo doesn't match that of the song. No problem for Cubase. Switch on musical mode, now it's right. Let's cycle it and add Melodyne. Now, musical mode is using Melodyne's algorithms for the tempo matching. You can see at once in Melodyne which notes were played in the sample. Let's bring back the other tracks.
You better watch out with your head in the clouds.
Okay, so at first it sounds all wrong, but it can quickly be moved to a better sounding register. Any changes you make are reflected in every repetition. These are ghost copies then. At first, that saves time. But to allow for variations later, let's make them real copies instead. Now, for each bar, you can introduce your own variations. Okay, let's listen to a longer cycle. This is still musically very monotonous, but it doesn't have to stay that way. Open the chord track in Melodyne. Right-click to get the chords from Cubase, and select for the background the setting Chords. The display now differs completely from the standard piano grid. A quick explanation. Pitches belonging to the chord are shown in white, and those foreign to the chord in gray. Since the chords keep changing, so does the background pattern, always following the Cubase chord track. But the sample does not yet reflect the changes in the background pattern. That's why it all still sounds a bit boring. Now, change the snap setting. Choose chords here too. Then just double-click, and the sample notes snap instantly to pitches matching the chord. If you like, you can change the register, say, like this. Now choose a different background. Chord scale, for example, for a wider selection of suitable pitches. In the following bars, I've done a bit of preparation. Split a few notes and added a few here and there by copy and paste. With that, the originally short and very uniform sample is now playing along with the song, like a real musician. A quick recap of the workflow, this time with a different sample. Drag and drop, musical mode on, add Melodyne, create repetitions as real copies. Show the chord track in Melodyne and link it with Cubase. Set the grid to chords, the snap too, and double click. Voila, a nice piano part. And if you like, you can enter extended chords in Cubase, as I've done here, for more pitch options and greater scope for creativity in Melodyne. Has that awakened your curiosity? Then try it out with your own samples. Have fun. Until the seas run dry.